Test. 2 minutes and we begin. The children are pumped to perform for you tonight. They've been rehearsing for weeks and not sleeping for weeks. So if you could come on stage, honey and children. We have a packed program. An hour and a half of one after the other. And I might as well tell you right now that it could go a little longer, so if you do have to leave, feel free. There are envelopes on the tables for memberships and donations. So I'd like to see a bunch of wallets open up. Okay, we are going to start with O Canada. It's a 150-year celebration this year. Well, we do have a few songs and dances, and I won't be dancing in regards to our celebrating of 150-year. Yeah, and if you could stand with us, we'd appreciate it.
And upright is he.
52.
Solid rock, I this next selection is a Baroque piece. It's written by Handel. It's from his well-known Handel's Messiah. It's taken from out of the scriptures, Matthew 11, verses 28 and 29. It's called Come Unto Him. We will be playing Mountain Spring by Dean Marshall. Thank you.
good evening. Thank you all so much for coming to this event. My name is Juliana Baldwin. I'm Grand Prairie Voice for Life's community educator and office manager. And I get to work with a fabulous board that helped put this together, as well as the Beagle family and Major's homestyle restaurant. And so I just wanted to thank you so much for choosing to invest your time, your finances, and support into this event and this organization. Voice for Life continues to exist solely by the generosity of those much like yourselves, those who believe in the value of free, fact-based, sourced information being offered to today's youth regarding a variety of health topics. So who are we, and what do we do? Well, we are a nonprofit, non-political organization whose main priority is to foster respect for human life in all its various stages of development, from conception to death. We do this through our health presentations that we offer to schools and community groups through the Peace Region. We've been doing this for over 25 years now and are truly excited about the progression of Grand Prairie Voice for Life and the advances it's made in the Peace Region community. I just found this out, a little fun fact, but Mrs. Lynette Beagle was the first educator for Grand Prairie Voice to Life, so I feel honored to be walking in her first footsteps. It is our joy to partner with the school system teachers who work tirelessly to provide education for the children under their care. Why do we do this? Well, young people face important decisions about relationships, sexuality, and sexual behavior every day. Bet you didn't think you were going to hear about that in this presentation tonight, but the decisions they make today can impact their health and well-being for the rest of their lives. We as an organization have taken on the challenge to prepare youth by providing them with comprehensive sexual health education that gives them the tools they need to make healthy and educated decisions. But we do more than just have conversations about abstinence and contraception to help young people avoid unplanned pregnancies or disease. We provide them with fact-based, age-appropriate, Alberta health curriculum-approved information and skills necessary to help them take personal responsibility for their health and well-being. The topics we cover in order from kindergarten to grade 12 are You Are Special, Growing Up, Puberty, male and female anatomy, fetology, and abstinence. In abstinence, we cover a variety of topics such as teen pregnancy, substance abuse, STIs, media's influence on today's youth, contraceptives, consent, and much more. According to the Advocates for Youth website, studies show sexual health education is effective in assisting young people to make better sexual health decisions. I have seen the impact of Grand Prairie Voice for Life presentations and what impact they've made as they leave the classrooms. I'm honored that I get to be part of making a difference in these children's lives. It is, however, important to recognize a child's main educator is his or her parents. I'm sure there are many parents in the room. Maybe some are thinking, oh yes, someone else is going to be talking to my kids about this stuff. And while I'm happy to assist, I want to encourage you with this fact. Nearly 87% of adolescents agree that it would be easier to postpone sexual activity and avoid adolescent pregnancies if they were able to have more open and honest conversations about these topics with their parents, not with their educators. Our frontal lobes, where we make decisions based off of long-term effects and consequences, is not fully developed until we're between the ages of 20 and 25. So youth cannot actually handle the responsibility and long-term effects of sex with one or with multiple partners. They need sound advice and information to make informed decisions regarding this topic. There are four hormones that are released during a sexual intercourse to bond us with that person. And their brains can't tell the difference between a one-night stand and their wedding night. So they will continue to make and break emotional, physical, and mental bonds. It's information like this that they need to make sound decisions regarding their sex life. And they want you to tell them about it. Fathers, I'd also like to encourage you and acknowledge the role you play in your daughters' and sons' lives. If your daughters know how to be respected and your sons know how to respect, you will be creating a ripple effect for generations to come. You are the first male your daughter will ever know love from. You are creating the example for the qualities she is to look for and admire in a man. You are the first male role model for your sons as well. You are the one they look up to on how to be a man. Your sons will be husbands and fathers one day. You are raising the future husbands, fathers, wives, and mothers of this community. So parents, I want to encourage you to talk to your kids about topics surrounding sex. Sex is not awkward. It's just real life. Help them see the wonder and joy of sex in safe, committed, covenant relationship. Build excitement in them to wait for the best sex. See it as a privilege that your kids would trust you to discuss a vulnerable but very real topic with you. Some of you may be wondering, well, now that I know that my thoughts matter to my kids, where do I start? Well, I'm glad you asked. This year, Grand Prairie Voice for Life has put together a brand new presentation for parents only called The Sex Talks, based off of the book by Joanna Hyatt. It is an interactive presentation for parents to know when, how, and why they should talk with their kids about sex and all the in-betweens. If you are interested in attending one of these presentations, we have an upcoming workshop on November 24th at 7 p.m. at the Grand Prairie Volunteer Service Bureau. For more information, please come see me at my booth. Thank you for having me speak here today. Again, all of our presentations are free, age-appropriate, and in accordance with Alberta Health Curriculum. If you're interested in information or booking, again, just come see me at the booth. Thank you all so much for being here, and I hope you enjoy your evening.
Awesome job, Julian. Awesome.
And I have choreographed a song written by Leanna Clausen. She is Canadian. The song was inspired by when the Lord told her to go to one end of Canada, to the East Coast, and dip her foot in the Atlantic Ocean, and then go to the Pacific and dip her toe in the Pacific Ocean. And the story goes that then the Lord would give her a song, and this is that song. Especially in remembrance, as Remembrance Day is coming up, this song is very special to us, as well as in celebration of Canada's 150 years. This song can be applied to the foundation of our country, but it can also be applied to many situations relating to our families and the body of Messiah.
My song for Canada.
How many times I've seen that song and it still chokes me up. Just to give you a little history, going on 10 years, we've been traveling Western Canada, and we started in Fairview at the seniors' homes, some of the loneliest people around. And we've traveled from Lacrete all the way down to Lethbridge, Red Deer, into BC, Kelowna, and make our rounds. We've been very, very blessed in visiting and getting to know the seniors. My children love the seniors. And so we've been very blessed. I want to just tell you a little bit about my past. And 32 years ago, I was a drunk, knocking on a door for a bed to sleep. Severe alcoholism, 3 packs of cigarettes a day. I was a functioning alcoholic. At Kenworth, I was sales manager, fairly lucrative income. One day my sister came into my office and asked me if I wanted to ask Jesus to come into my heart. And I fought it for years, but that was the day. And I started to weep and I started to heave. I went into the washroom and I looked in the mirror and God showed me a very lonely man that had no direction and just wanted to be loved. I fell to my knees, on my face actually, and repented of my sins. That's the key, folks. Repented of my sins. And I felt him pick me up off the floor and told me he loved me and forgave me. First time in my life I felt true love. Now, because he forgave me, I can do that with my family, my children. And Jillian did an incredible job on mentioning about us men, filling in that spot till God brings the right man. And I pray, not daily, but I should, about the right men coming into my home, because I've got such is going to sing a song? Almost. Some of you here probably know me from before, and I give all the credit to my Father in heaven that he can change anyone's life. He's never too busy. The 1-800 number is always, always open. And as I look, I see him with his hand out. Come. And all you got to do is grab onto it. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
To care, who knows what means.
Blossom Special.
Your programs tell you that Mary Poppins was going to perform tonight, and she couldn't make it. Sorry about that.
Thank you.
to a remote forest to hunt moose. The pilot dropped them off and was told to pick them up 2 weeks later. Sure enough, the pilot was back and was told and was surprised to see three big moose in between the two hunters. The pilot freaked and said, "There's no way my little plane can haul the three of us plus three big moose." Well, the hunters were miffed. They said, "Wait a minute, buddy. Every year we come to this spot, and every year we shoot three moose. And the pilots have just tied them onto the top of their planes, and their planes were no bigger than yours." Well, the pilot couldn't argue with experience, so he strapped those three moose onto the top of his plane and started off down the runway. It seemed forever till he finally got off the ground, just clearing the treetops. After about 20 miles of the plane creaking, moaning, and groaning, they crashed into the side of a mountain. The three men crawled out of the wreckage, brushed themselves off, and the pilot said, "Would either of you happen to know where we are?" One of the hunters sighed and said, "Yeah, the same place we crash every year."
Linnea and I will be playing a song called Two Guitars, a Russian gypsy folk song.
one of the old favorites. Everyone really, really enjoys that rose wherever we go. And remember my first story when I gave my life to Christ? You remember that? It was not long ago. Anyway, I took my life back into my own hands for a time. We had Brianne and Brooklyn, who are 25, twins. And then I decided that I would get a vasectomy. Everybody knows what that is. 80% of men now get a vasectomy. I wanted the pleasure and the fun, no responsibility. My wife would hold a baby and tears would flow down her cheeks. And I'd try to push that away. 4.5 years I did. And one day the Holy Spirit got a hold of me and said, I thought you made a commitment to me. Why would you take and make your own decision in cutting off all the blessings I have for you? That day I wept. I fell to my knees. I phoned my wife, said, book me in. I'm going for a reversal. A reversal today is $5,000. They'll snip you for nothing. That's a fact. And I'd like my 7 children to come up. And that is the result of one man's decision. One man's decision can change generations. And we would not be here today if it wasn't that conviction. Thank you, Father. So we will, 'tis so sweet to trust in Jesus.
Thank you.
Elohim.
Speak to the heart of Jerusalem and cry out to her that her hard service is completed, that her crookedness is pardoned, that she has received from the hand of Yahweh double for all her sins.
The voice of one crying in the wilderness.
Prepare the way of Yahweh, make straight in the desert a highway for our God.
And let every valley be raised, and every mountain and hill made low, and the steep places shall become level, and the rough places smooth. And the esteem of Yahweh shall be revealed, and all flesh together shall see it, for the mouth of Yahweh has spoken.
The voice said,
cry out.
And he said,
what shall I cry?
All flesh is grass, and all of its loving commitment is like the flower of the field.
Grass shall wither, the flower shall fade, when the Spirit of God blows upon it.
Truly, the people are grass.
Grass shall wither, the flower shall fade, but the word of Yahweh stands forever.
You who bring good news to Zion, get up into the high mountain.
You who bring good tidings to Jerusalem, lift up your voice with strength. Lift it up, be not afraid. Say to the cities of Judah,
behold your Elohim.
See, the Master Yahweh comes as strength, and his arm rules for him.
Behold, his reward is with him, and his recompense before him.
He feeds his flock like a shepherd,
and gathers lambs with his arms,
and carries them in his bosom, gently leading those that are with young.
Who has measured the waters in the hollow of his hand, and measured the heavens with a span, and contained the dust of the earth in a measure, and weighed the mountains in scales, and the hills in a balance?
Who has meted out the Spirit of Yahweh, or as a counselor taught him? With whom did he take counsel, and who instructed him and taught him in the path of right ruling?
Who taught him knowledge and showed him in the way of understanding?
See, nations are as a drop in a bucket, and are reckoned as dust on the balance. Behold, he lifts up isles as fine dust,
and Lebanon is not sufficient to burn, nor its beasts enough for an ascending offering. All nations before him are as a non-entity, and they are likened unto him as less than a speck and emptiness.
Unto whom would you liken Elohim?
And what likeness would you compare unto him?
Behold, the workman molds a graven image, and the goldsmith overspreads it with gold, and the silversmith casts silver chains. He who is too poor for such an offering chooses a tree that does not rot. He seeks for himself a skilled craftsman to prepare a carved image that does not totter.
Did you not know? Have you not heard?
Has it not been declared to you from the beginning?
Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth?
It is he who sits upon the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers.
Who stretches out the heavens like a curtain, and spreads them out like a tent to dwell in.
Who brings princes to naught, and shall make the rulers of the earth as emptiness.
Hardly has it been planted, hardly have they been sown, hardly has their stock taken root in the earth, when he shall blow upon them, and they wither, and the whirlwind take them away like stubble.
And to whom would you liken Elohim? And to whom am I compared? Says Yahweh, the set apart one.
Lift up your eyes on high and see.
Who has created these?
He is bringing out their host by number. He calls them all by name. By the greatness of ability and potent of power, a man is not lacking.
Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from Yahweh, and my rights are overlooked by my Elohim?
Did you not know? Have you not heard?
Has it not been declared to you from the foundations of the earth?
Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth?
It is he who sits upon the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers.
Even the youth shall faint and be weary,
and young men shall stumble and fall.
next song is called What Does God Require of You? It's a song that I wrote, and it's taken from Deuteronomy chapters 10 and 11, different selected verses throughout there.
To love him and serve him. amazing thank you to the Beagles for
Style for the wonderful meal. I would like to thank Joe Doherty, who did all the centerpieces and provided them. I would like to thank all the silent auction donors who filled our table so beautifully. Thank you. And I would like to thank our sponsors, who without them, we couldn't change lives. Well, I shouldn't say change lives, change choices for the students in the schools. They make better choices. And I especially want to thank you for coming out here. God bless you all.
And if we could, we got one more song to play. If we could just request again that you just take the envelopes and give generously to this cause. And also for memberships are there also. And I did make a mistake earlier. I have to apologize for this. My wife is 53, not 52. Again soon. Thanks again. Thank you very much. We appreciate that a lot.